So perception matters. I've talked about data visualization. I've talked about it's reducing cognitive load and making it easier for us to find our findings. That all requires making the right picture. And making the right picture means making a picture that your brain can decode. Well, that means understanding a little bit about how your brain does the decoding. So let's have an example of one particular kind of decoding. This is sunspot data from 1749 to, I believe, 1924. And these data, it's a very, very famous data set. You're just counting the spots that appear on the sun in a yearly basis. And the number of spots is we're associating with solar activity. This regular pattern, up and down, this 11-year cycle. And this cycle is very, very well known. It tells us something about the nature of the sun. William Cleveland, who has his laboratory where he studies human perception, learned a good bit about the fact that human beings have an eye that's okay at registering a 45-degree angle. Real deviations from that, we start to be less good at. And so what you see in this version of the picture, it just appears to go straight up, and then almost straight down, and then almost straight up, and then almost straight down. He wondered whether there was more that we could see if we attended to the fact that we tend to be pretty good at seeing slight deviations from 45 degrees, but not so good at steeper angles. So he shrunk down the scale of the graph. He squashed the graphic until, on average, the lines were at about 45 degrees. And this pattern emerged. Looking closely at it, he was able to see not just that same repeating pattern, 11 years, the same pattern of years as before. He also was able to see the structure of the increase. It was a rapid increase and then a tapering off. In most cases, that's what he saw. Instead of just straight up and straight down, which is what the first graph shows, it's actually up and then down. By understanding how we perceive pictures, he was discovering a new insight into the nature of the working of the sun. That sunspots represent a kind of phenomena which has a rapid start and then a petering decline. That points to something deep inside the sun, and I do not know what it is, but I know it's raised some questions, and we're trying to get answers to them, and it's because of having the right picture.